it's Tyrone from tyronesham.com. In today's tutorial, I want to share with you the payment method that I currently use to pay virtual assistants on virtual staff. A question that I've been asked regularly is, how come you don't use Zoom anymore? And the reason why is because Zoom's only restricted now to the US. And I used to use Zoom because its fees were lower than PayPal, but because Zoom has been restricted, and because I'm in Australia, and no doubt there are many people outside the States outsourcing to the Philippines, you need to find another method. And yes, PayPal is a little bit more expensive, but I found quite a good way to be able to pay at a lower rate in comparison to using Zoom. So what I'm going to be showing you right now is how I use what we call the mass payment system in PayPal. Not the normal way, but the mass payment system in PayPal. And this method actually reduces your fees. It does require you to submit a text file and also do some extra little bit clicking through, but it will save you on the fees in comparison to paying $4 US or so per transaction. You might be paying up to a dollar at most, so it's about four times less. Alright, so let's just jump over and I'll show you how to set it up inside your system. Firstly, what I suggest you do is log into your PayPal account by just simply going paypal.com. So I'll log in right now, and once I've logged in, I'll usually go to the send money to be able to send money to my virtual assistant. And I usually do this on a monthly basis. Okay, so if you want to be able to send money, this is the normal way to do it. You just type in to whoever, and then you type in your amount here, and then you click services, and then click continue right down here. That way, usually either your virtual assistant or your virtual staff will get charged a fee of about $4 or $5 per transaction. And also you probably might get charged as well, depending on which country you're in. Alternatively, I use this method called make a mass payment. And I've just clicked on it. All right, so to make a mass payment, this is what you do. You can send up to 5,000 payments at once. Say you've got 10 virtual staff in your company. You can actually post it all inside this little text file that I'll show you how to create, and then upload it once, and you do all the payments all at once. So reading it over here says you can upload a payment file on this page, and then you emit your information using APIs. That's two methods. What I recommend you do is using a payment file, and it's just a simple text file or a CSV file. Alright, all you have to do is simply select your file by clicking upload here, and then look for your file. Alright, so I've uploaded a file called masspayment.txt, and you want to sort the payment receipts identified by the email address, and then in your email subject you can type something in. This is your transaction or your invoice payment, and then you can type your receipt. I usually just ignore those fields. The most important thing is to process your payment. And once you've done that, just simply hit the review button, and what will happen, it will take you through that payment process, and it will automatically pay to your virtual assistant the amounts that they require. Alright, so that's how you set it up in mass payment. What I want to show you right now is how to set up this text file that you uploaded. So we'll go to the text file now. Alright, as you can see here, this is the masspayment.txt file. And all it is you just got to type in three simple fields. The first field is the email address that you're going to be sending the payment to. So it's the PayPal email. Could be anything, test@yahoo.com or thename@yahoo.com. Then the amount without dollar sign or any currency sign. So 32531. And then USD or whatever payment currency it is. And in between here, this is all tabs. If you click the tab key, these are all tabs. And then once you've done that, that's the first payment that I want to make to the first person. Then you hit the enter button, and then it will create a new line for you, and you do exactly the same thing. And you can pay up to many, many different currencies that are available inside PayPal. If you do it this method, you'll save quite a lot of money on your transaction fees. So this is just a little tip that I wanted to share with you today. I hope that you can also implement this into your system. It's something that I know a lot of people have been struggling with regards to not having Zoom anymore to pay into the Philippines. But there are other methods out there. But I think, in my opinion, PayPal using the mass payment method is probably the easiest and the simplest method out there that will keep your fees down or quite low. If you have any more feedback and you find other really good payment systems that you can recommend, love to hear about it too. So just leave it down in the comment section here, and I'd love to hear your feedback as well too. I'd love you to also tweet this and get it out into Facebook as well, and just to share it with people, because I know that a lot of people who are running businesses with virtual assistants will probably find that this tip is quite handy and quite helpful too. All right, that's it for me today. I hope you've enjoyed the video that I presented for you today. My name's Tyrone from tyroneshum.com. Have a great day, and I'll see you in the next video.